the avatar starts dancing rumba instead of salsa, basically.
I can tell it to stop or to change. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so it's fully decentralized. So we've allowed in our system that everyone can have their own AI rather than always using the AI of even our future multiverse or using open AIs. This is a huge thing because large companies so far, they had the approach, same as I just make that example now. I don't even have to use the name, but very large, let's say most well-known AI social media platforms that are now leaders in the AI space because they're of course also top managers of user data. Basically, they're using all the users' data to train their own large language models and systems. The good thing is that they have made those large language models now also available in an open source so that people can use it, people can work with it, people can train it. But still, this is completely new for many people. So let's say for the broad masses, there's, of course, you know, excited developers since day one, since the first open source large language model was available, they started working with it and testing it, which is great because it allows individuals to have their own large language model and to let it work for them. And now again, to get back to that part, still again, in regards to convenience, many people are still using, for example, ChatGPT or let's say systems that are owned by and all the information that are the output that is created by those large language models, they're basically still owned by those large companies. So we really also there want to empower and educate the people. You should have your own large language model that is trained on your own data, where you have the control over it, where you can at any time have the possibility to pull the plug, pull out the electricity, and it basically starts operating. Where you and also to educate the people how they can use this technology, use it for their own benefit with the full control and the full management over it, and then also inspire them in many ways of how it can be used and showing them, leading them by example, basically of how it can be put to use. In not only for their own avatar, but for their own, for example, fully automatized shop, store, factory, vehicle, you know, entire customized city or even an entire country. But we really want to empower decentralization, full own ownership and management rather than dependency large provider. So this is very important for us. Long story short.
So we can say there are many, many possibilities that can be used with AI, and Future Multiverse shows us what these are. We have the complete control over the AI, over our own avatar, because we can plug ourselves out every time. We can train our avatars. So we have the possibility to tell them what to do and what not to do. In your example of the spoon, we are the healthy side of the spoon, and we won't use it to throw it to anywhere. We want to use the AI and to make the world a better place, because this is the first vision of Future Multiverse, and AI is great success for us. What do you think? Without AI, many things we use AI for in Future Multiverse. Yeah.
Definitely. Also, even the softwares that we're using for producing the design renderings, etc. So AI is basically a core part already for all the different processes of our platform. Let's say most different parts of the system, and it's very helpful, in fact. But it's always, again, how do you use the spoon?
Keep control and be part of the future multiverse. That's it. Yeah. And then you can try to get adopted to this, to use it, to see what AI is good for, and to use it for your own purposes.
And also a very important point, if we, of course, like this is the good thing, like the way of how we build our system is we give everyone the opportunity to actually own their own data, to train their own large language model, to put it to use in a good way on our platform. And anyone who is misbehaving, we have the possibility to disconnect their API. So we can basically, if people are misbehave on our platform, we have regulatory frameworks, we're going to have, let's say, a security system integrated where basically people can report, let's say, misbehaviors by users, so that basically they can, you know, get either a warning, or they can be directly disconnected. To reconnect, they basically have to apply for it, but also they could be banned from the platform. So anytime when there's, let's say, either somebody is doing directly actively misbehaving on the platform, or their AI is misbehaving on the platform, we also have the possibility there to cut the API. So we've built it in a, let's say, a hybrid way of giving everyone full control of ability of full ownership, but on the other side, having the possibility to be in control of our own large language model and, let's say, how our platform is used. And people can use it in a good way, in a responsible way, to create impact, to do good, and to use the platform in the way that our vision is. If they don't comply with those terms, then reserve the rights to also disconnect them. What gives them a possibility, or their AI a possibility, to recalibrate and to learn to become better and then reconnect at a point in time where maybe this behavior has been improved. So literally, this is also how AI actually learns, but not only AI, but actually, again, AI is built on the, let's say, thinking processes of humans. Very interesting. But what I wanted to say is, for example, if you have a certain dance move you're recording, or a certain walk, and you're walking in a certain way, you're talking in a certain way, you're wearing a specific hat like you do, for example, and or a certain pair of glasses, then you can ensure, or we can make sure that we, when we render this hat for you, or this glass, for example, we design it, we give it to you, it's only going to be stored and managed on your device. You can stream it to the platform and no one can simply say, oh, I'm going to Stefan and I'm taking the hat and I'm walking away, or they cannot copy your hat simply. Like they can now, for example, go on Google Images, they put in the name of a company and they just download the image. It's not possible. We can ensure in this way that you also, those assets or elements that we have created for you, we delete again on our side. It's only running on your side. You can stream it to the platform, and also your AI or your large language model, certain intellectual property, for example. You are an author of a certain book, or you are a trainer, coach, or you have certain knowledge that others don't have. People cannot simply, let's say, copy all of the data that are stored on your device that you're sharing with others, because you can train your avatar only under certain conditions that somebody, for example, paid for your course or paid for your event, for example, where you're speaking on stage or whatsoever, that then those certain conditions you are sharing, or your avatar even automatized, your AI, while you are asleep or while you're doing something completely different, you can automatize this, that you, under certain conditions, when somebody paid for your event ticket or paid you for a certain course, that then your AI-empowered avatar is then sharing certain informations. So for courses, fully automated. So it's very fascinating on how AI can be used on our platform, mechanisms into place that people don't have to be afraid their AI large language model becoming smarter and learning new skills and becoming better, because we have mechanisms in place that we can make sure that those, the individual knowledge, the individual skills of the real person, but also of the large language model, are put to good use, and where we basically have control mechanisms in place. Also for the future development of this platform, a large language model is not coming out of control, but is really directed and, let's say, guided to the right direction.
I'm pretty sure we have to learn a lot about AI in the future. We are just in the beginning. Some people are in AI since 20 years, but we are in the beginning. Yeah. And now we have the future multiverse to show what AI is good for. Dear Simon, thank you very much for your time. We learned a lot about AI, and I think many things are clearer now. We don't have to be afraid of anything. We have the future multiverse, and it's the good side of the end. And we can invite everyone to go use the future multiverse to see what AI is good for, and to train their own avatar. And I think there will be many, many more years to learn about AI, and Future Multiverse is the perfect platform to do this. So thanks again for your time, and everyone else outside, just stay tuned on this channel and follow us to the next episode of Ask the Founder again. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Thank you, and have a great day.